Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. To underhanger, my very enough vision and ensure is the full distribution access for people is a platform to sustainable development goals. And it become the joint goal which are proclaimed by UN member countries, include Indonesia. And it is a hope it will be realized in 2030. But it is unfortunately because until today, the nature and cases of malnutrition still exist around us. Hunger is still a problem in Indonesia. According to the 2019 Global Hunger Index, Indonesia is ranked 70 out of 117 countries. This means that the problem of hunger in Indonesia has entered a serious level with a score of 20.1. So it needs more attention to be handled. The problem of hunger and malnutrition seems to be a hidden problem in Indonesia. This condition becomes worse, but it is not only because of pandemic, but also because of some factors. According to the data from the Ministry of Agriculture in 2019, Papua and West Papua are the two provinces with the worst results in that in Indonesia. Hello, my name is Rasul Sana. I am a delegation of Universitas Pendidikan Muhammadiyah Sarawak in program Mahasiswa Berprestasi Program Sarjana in 2021. Here, I will inform you about hunger and malnutrition that still happening in Papua region. And I also will offer some solution for this problem. In the last decade, most of Papua has changed their food consumption patterns from eating sweet potatoes and sago to rice. It is recorded that as many as 51% of people in Papua and 75% in West Papua depend on food that comes from outside Papua, especially rice. In the book, The Ethnography of Papua Development, it is revealed that the discussion of food security in Papua is caused by human factor rather than natural factor. Symptoms of food surplus appear when the community leaves their field. It is made worse by the incessant of rusting. We knew it as right for the field and cheap. This is where the lazy culture comes from and the community slowly leaves their activity in field. In addition, snacks are easy to find in small food stalls. Another problem is hunger the field becomes a target for pigs that get around the field and looking for food. Most of the pigs found in the village are not kept in cages. They are left to look for their own food. This issue is either related to the goal of sustainable development goals number 2. Namely, zero hunger or eliminating hunger, achieving food security and good nutrition, and increasing sustainable agriculture. To achieve the goals of no hunger by 2030, targets are set which are measured through indicators. The targets are eliminating hunger and maximizing doubling agricultural productivity, ensuring sustainable food agriculture, managing genetic diversity and increasing agricultural productivity capacity. Some of the solutions offered to solve this problem include: first, make village a center of local food by agriculture on food security in Papua without disturbing the values of local knowledge they have. Second, is the restore the role of local food as natural food security. The potential of tubers such as sweet potatoes, taro, and sago is very large. In addition to local food needs, it can also be exported for basic ingredients for other process industries. Third, to educate research about food consumption based on local food. According to the solution that have been offered, of course, we must work together joint cooperation, the government, the private sector, and the people in various regions to be more on burdens is achieving SDGs goals number 2. that without us zero hunger.